Hello, everyone. Hello. I'm so excited to be here in Denver. I'm really so excited.
I'm so excited,
and I can't yet hide it. I don't want to lose control, and I don't think I like it. Yeah, thank you. So I'm really excited to be here because here in Denver, they created my childhood TV series, which is Dynasty. Do you remember Black and Crystal and Alexis? Okay, so I've came here from Israel, which is 17 hours of flight, and I came here to show you how to create your dashboard plugin with React. And let's see the people in the audience. So how many front-end developers do we have here? Please raise your hand. Wow. Most of you are back-end developers. Okay. So, as you can see, I am a professional stylist superstar. And now, for real, I'm over 12 years in the cloud sector for VMware and Nokia right now. I'm a UI tech leader in Nokia and core contributor for the Vitrage project, which is an Horizon plugin. And also, I have a side project, which is my family. So let me tell you a story. Once upon a time, there was OpenStack Horizon, and they've created an AngularJS plugin so we can do some nice dashboards. And this time, it was very nice, and we created the Vitrage dashboard. As you can see in the background, it has some topology, alarms, root cause analysis, some monitoring data, and entity graph. And this time was really cool because we have like the AngularJS features as scope, digest, and transclusion. And I've been participating in some NG conferences, and I've met Mishko Haveri, which is the father of AngularJS. So yeah, really, it was a really good time. But you know, time passes, 5 years, new technologies, new libraries came, new frameworks, and also some new brand baby came to world, but Horizon, it just got frozen. Horizon, let's call it Horizon. Okay, so at this point, I understand that we have a problem. And I go to Google, and I just typed how to resolve a big, really, really big critical problem in your life. And then I find something that I want to share with you. It's a really tip for life. So be with me. Do you have a problem in your life? No. Then why worry? Do you have a problem in your life? Yes. Can you do something about it? Yes. Then why worry? Do you have a problem in your life? Yes. Can you do something about it? No. Then why worry? Okay, so we understand the problem. We have the Horizon, and it still supports only the AngularJS framework, AngularJS version 1. Today we have version 8. So, okay, let's wait. Probably someone from this big community will resolve it for us, right? But we already waited for 5 years, and nobody did nothing yet. So at this point, I understand that I have to do something. So I just checked in the local JavaScript group that I have. And you don't know Hebrew, but you know the words plugin, Horizon, and OpenStack. And it's enough to understand. And also, you can see that I've got no comments. And the only like I've got is from my friend, Shai Resnick, which is the administrator of the group. Okay, so at this point, I understand that I have to do it. But as you can see, Nokia, I don't have time to do it because I have a lot of work to do. So I've created a team. I'm from Nokia, right? I know how to connect between people. That's what the logo said, right? So I have it probably in my blood, and I created this amazing team. So the first idiot up, this is me. And I have Ivan, the PTL from Horizon, from Mirantis, with the longest family name in the world that I saw. And also I have Noor Yamin from Exalt, which is a subcontractor for Nokia. So at this point, Noor should be here with me on the stage, but she couldn't. So I want to thank Noor very much. Everybody, please make noise to Noor. She made a lot of this for the project. Woo! Thank you. So this team had to be connected, everyone in another place. So we can connect by everything, like Slack, WhatsApp, Outlook, or I don't know, Microsoft Team. But how is the Horizon OpenStack, how they are connected? It's MIRC, M-I-R-C solution, like Morse code, it's old fashioned, but leave it. Finally, we've succeeded. We've succeeded to create a React application inside Horizon. And we find three solutions. Let's go over the steps. So the first one was a standalone application, only a Create React app versus the APIs of OpenStack. But that's what we didn't want it because we wanted it to be integrated in Horizon. So the second one was an Angular directive, the old Angular one, which is like wrapping the new React framework. But it was like, you know, like scratching your ear this way, like old with new. Finally, we've got to a customized Horizon plugin with a customized webpack. And as you can see in the demo, we will see now the React dashboard plugin. We can see some nice dashboard with a nice table, gauges, and charts. Also, all the data here, the data flow is with Mobix. You can do it also with Redux. Any library that you can choose in package JSON. And you can create really nice dashboard in Horizon. OK, so what we've just seen, we saw the Horizon based on Django, plus the React plugin, with some of the dependencies that I just mentioned. Also, style components for the CSS. OK, now, I want to introduce Ivan, which is the PTL of Horizon. And I've just met him yesterday, even though we are working for the last 3 months together. But this is the way of the community working. So welcome, Ivan. Thank you.
Thank you, Alan. So my part won't be so funny and exciting like Alan's one, but I will talk about more technical stuff. I am Horizon PTL. I am OpenStack developer in Mirantis, and I'm working both on client side and backend. So what's the current issue with OpenStack Horizon? It's old style Django-based application, right? Mostly in Python. So we've got some JavaScript included. In time when Django started, nobody knows what is single page application, modern frameworks, etc. So we as Python developers created some ecstatic packages to include JavaScript into Python to work with them. And we use JavaScript using script tags like nobody does in modern frontend development. So we try to fix all these issues and integrate modern single-page application on the newest frameworks into Horizon. We will talk about React, but the same way you can implement Horizon plugin using Vue.js, Angular 5, or so on. So it's the same solution, but different frameworks. So how did we do it? It's really easy. We just created React application and modified Webpack to create a bundle with two files. We need to have a JavaScript file with all your script included. It's your application, dependencies like React, Mobix, and so on. And of course, you need some CSS file with your styles. You can use LESS, SAS, CSS in JS, but Webpack will build it in CSS. And you no need to use ecstatic anymore. So as web developers, front-end developers, you know what is Node.js, NPM packages, you just need to NPM install, React, NPM install Mobix, and everything will work. Unfortunately, you have to deal with backend and Python a bit more because Horizon based on Python and you need to create Horizon plugin with few Python scripts. And This Python script will communicate with OpenStack APIs and provide API for your JavaScript application. This configuration provides the ability to use modern technologies for web frameworks, the latest libraries for like React, Vue, and so on. It provides better backend and frontend experience because for now it's really independent frontend and backend. Unfortunately, we didn't do everything yet, but we've got a working POC with integration of React and Horizon. We are working on build automation and CI for this stuff. I'm pretty sure that our awesome infra team and Zul helped us a lot. We don't care about packaging anymore because we've got NPM packages. So we don't need to create Xtatic for any JavaScript libraries you want to add. And that's all.
Don't wait for tomorrow. Don't wait for tomorrow. Build your React plugin today. So we've created for you some repositories in GitHub so you can do it step by step. And good luck. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Watch me whip, kill it. Watch me nay nay. Okay. Now watch me whip, whip. Watch me nay nay. Can you do it? Now watch me. Ooh, watch me. Watch me. Ooh, watch me. Watch me. Ooh, watch me. Watch me. Ooh, okay.
Together, 'cause we don't everyone. Thank you for coming to Tech Lightning Talk. I'm Hyunsik Yang from South Korea. I'm working in the IISTRC. Today, I would like to talk about the brief introduction and Tech's project and future works. This is my contents. So at first, I will introduce about the Tech project briefly, and then I also present about the Tech integration with other projects for Tech industry. So what is the Tech? Tech is an open stack based NFV orchestration framework. So this is the NFV reference architecture, which is based on the Edge. So among these component, Tech correspond to the VNF manager and NFV orchestrator. And Tech is compatible with the Edge NFV environment. This is the Tech architecture. It consists of NFVO part, VNFM part, and NFV catalog. Basically, Tech supports two kinds of the beam. The first one is OpenStack. The other one is Kubernetes. And then this beam is managed by the infra driver in the Tech. And the NFVO include the function of the multi-site, the function of the beam and network services, and the VNF forwarding graph. And then VNFM include the management driver and the monitoring driver and the management of the VNF instance. And Tech support many kinds of the catalog descriptor, such as network service descriptor and the VNF forwarding descriptor and the VNF descriptors. And Tech also supports the horizon, so you can control the NFV the features through the horizon. This is a basic Tech workflow. So basically, Tech use templates. So when the administrator wants to create a VNF or the network services, just forward the template to the Techer. And Techer forward that information to heat translator, and heat translator, it translated from YAM-based template to the hot template. And then the heat translator forward that information to the heat. The heat recast the resources that need to generate the VNF. After creation of the VNF, the Techer can manage the VNF using the monitoring driver and the management driver. If SDN controller needs, Techer also request to the SDN controller to set up the data paths between the VNF. And then the Techer support several descriptor. One of the descriptor is a VNF forwarding descriptor. So if user use the VNF forwarding descriptor, user can make the VNF forwarding graph like this figure. And the Tech also supports the network service descriptor. So one of the big differences between the VNF forwarding descriptor and the network service descriptor is how many VNF forwarding descriptor forwarding graph you have. So network service descriptor can define the many VNF forwarding graph in the one template. One of as a perspective of the telco industry, one of the important issues, the fault management. So telco also support fault management. So basically, telco support the basic monitoring tool, such as ping, HTTP ping, and the monitoring, just monitoring driver. So it could be used for the health checking of the VNF. And the tech also supports a detailed monitoring tool. The alarm-based monitoring driver is, which is based on the AODH and the accelerometer, so it can use for checking the resources which used by the VNF. And the other monitoring tool is JAVIX-based monitoring tool. It could be used for the application level monitoring. And from now on, I just more detailed feature in the techer. So one of the feature is the JAVIX plugin. So this plugin is proposed to support the monitoring of the applications in the VNF. So with this driver, we can check the status of the applications. And another feature is the Kubernetes beam. Before this feature, OpenStack only support the OpenStack infra as a beam in the techer, but this feature support the Kubernetes beam, so you can deploy the Kubernetes containerized VNF to the Kubernetes using the techer. And based on the Kubernetes beam, we also support the containerized VNF. So to support the containerized VNF, techer make a translator between the Tosca and the Kubernetes. So techer translate that information from Tosca to the Kubernetes and forward to the Kubernetes. And Kubernetes deployed the containerized VNF according to the VNF descriptor. So this is the sample VNF descriptor. So you can define the containerized container information in here. And we also, in the techer support the two kinds of the VNF. One is the VM-based VNF, other is containerized VNF. So between them, to communicate each other, networking integration is required. So to do that, we also make an integrated networking solution using the Create Kubernetes. So with this feature, we also support the SFC for the hybrid VNF. So you can create the service function chaining with containerized VNF and the VM-based VNF. And this is the latest feature, this the resource reservations. The resource reservation also one of the big issues in the telco infra. So we made this feature for supporting the resource reservation. So this feature work with the Blazor project. So when you want to reserve the resources for the specific VNF, you can define that information, and then the techer follow that, and then deploy the VNF with the reservation policies. So you can deploy VNF with resource reservation policies. From now on, actually, we are working on techer, making more features in the techer. So we are so one of the target is to make it more close to the standardization. So we are consider the edge specification, and we want to change some part according to the edge. And then we are so focused on the stability, and then so many features about hybrid VNF and many kinds of the beam too. So this is my slide. Thank you for attending. So if you have any question or interested with techer, please free join to our IRC channel, techer. Thank you.